Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss first chapter of class 10 subject science. First chapter, chapter 1, chemical reactions and equations. Class 10 subject science, chemical reactions and equations. So before the discussions, let us try to understand chemical reactions and equations. We can understand this fact from our daily life also. Imagine that if milk is left in summer season at room temperature for long time, then what will happen? Grapes are fermented, foods are cooked. These all are chemical changes, chemical reactions are taking place, and result we know. So these all are, we can say that chemical reactions. Meal become curd, this is also chemical change. We know that bacteria was there, so this is also one type of chemical change. So chemical reactions taking place. So in our daily life, many examples are there where you can we are very much familiar about that, and we can say that knowingly or unknowingly we are well known about these chemical reactions now. So chemical reactions plays a vital role in our daily life also. In our most of the event or cases in our daily life, we can see this chemical reaction. So we need to know about the chemical reactions and how to write that chemical reactions, that is the equation. By using the chemical symbols, then we can represent these chemical reactions, and that is called chemical equations. We'll understand more later also. Throughout my discussion, we'll understand more also. Now, whatever the chemical reactions taking place, many changes can be seen. Change of state in chemical reaction. Change of state solid may become gas, liquid may become gas, gas can convert it to liquid. For example, this hydrogen, we know this gas, oxygen also gas, both reacts together forms the water, that is liquid. So earlier, before the reaction, they are in gaseous state, and after reactions that becomes liquid, that is in liquid state. So there is a change of state. So like this we can understand. Change in color also. If we immerse an iron rod in a beaker containing copper sulfate solution, then there will be change in color. What color, later also we have the discussion, so we can understand that time. So if we immerse a zinc rod in a copper sulfate solution in a beaker, then also there will be change in color. Next we can say that evolution of gas. Evolution of gas, that we can understand easily. Two chemicals when react, gas is evolving. For example, we can say that if we burn a cloth or paper, that forms the carbon dioxide gas. So that is also gas is evolving. Simple examples I have given. Change in temperature. Change in temperature. Change in temperature, we can say that If we purchase from the market quick lime, and if we dip in a water, then the pot becomes tremendously hot. That is also a chemical change, and temperature is rising. So we can say that change in temperature. Temperature earlier what was, and after the reaction there is a change in temperature. So these are the changes that may occur during the chemical reaction or after the chemical reaction. So if we see that these are the changes, then we can say there is a chemical reaction. So due to the chemical reactions, these are the changes may take place. I think you understand. Now we will discuss about the chemical equation. Chemical equation, that means simply we can say that the representation of chemical reaction. Simply we can say that the representation of chemical reaction. For example, if we burn a magnesium ribbon, then we can write this magnesium will react with oxygen. If we burn a magnesium ribbon, then we can say that magnesium is reacting with oxygen, because without oxygen nothing can be burned. So anything burning, that means reacting with oxygen. So magnesium burning, that means magnesium is reacting with oxygen. So we can say that it forms magnesium oxide. So this is the by spelling we have written. When we will represent this using the symbol, let us represent it. In place of magnesium we can write Mg, in place of oxygen we can write O2, and magnesium oxide, that means MgO. Magnesium, oxygen, magnesium oxide. So we can say that when magnesium reacting with oxygen, that means magnesium ribbon is burned, then magnesium oxide is formed. So this is the chemical equation. We have represented the chemical reaction between the magnesium and oxygen by this equation, that is called chemical equation. Now this chemical equation is called skeletal equation. This chemical equation is in the form of skeletal chemical equation. Skeletal chemical equation. Why skeletal? Because this is not balanced. Why it is called skeletal? That means imagine that a human being without flesh, only the skeleton, without flesh, that is the skeleton. So here also, without balancing the chemical equation, we can say this is chemical skeletal chemical equation. Now when we will balance it, then it will become balanced chemical equation. Now balance means what? Balancing means this is the reactant side, and this is product side. This is reactant side, this is product side. And we know that by the law of chemical combination, the mass must be conserved and the proportion is always remain constant. These are the two laws followed by the chemicals at the time of combining. So here mass is not same. Here 1 mg, here 2 oxygen, here 1 mg but 1 oxygen. So this is not a balanced chemical equation. This is called skeletal chemical equation because it is not balanced. So let us balance it. I think you understand. Magnesium, how many there? 1 magnesium. How many oxygen there? 2 oxygens. As oxygen always at the time of writing, oxygen is divalent atom, so we have to write O2. So we cannot write only O. A single O is atom, one atom. But oxygen in the nature is available as O2, that means oxygen gas. So they are two oxygen, but they are only one oxygen. So it is not balanced. Both side must be balanced. That means both side must be number of atom must be same. So here one magnesium atom, here two oxygen atom, but here one oxygen atom. So at the time of balancing the chemical equation, we will always balance first. We will always balance first which one is odd number. They are two, but they are one. This is odd number there. So there we must have to give first two. We cannot write there anything because this is the chemical formula of magnesium oxide. This formula cannot be changed ever. So we cannot write anything at the bottom. Cannot write anything at the suffix. So whatever we need to require to balance it, we can write there. There only. We cannot write there or there or there or there. We cannot increase anything there. We have to increase there only. So when I will write two there, why have I written two there? Because two oxygen, so we need to balance there. That side also must be two oxygen. So that's why they are two written. But at the same time, what happened? When I have written two there, then magnesium became two. But this side magnesium one. So let us give there two. So now you see two magnesium, two oxygen. There this in product side also two magnesium, two oxygen. This two is for both. So here two magnesium, two oxygen. This is called balanced chemical equation. This is called balanced chemical equation. Whenever we will write any example, anything in the answer sheet or in exam paper, any reaction, whenever we will write, always you must have to remember, always we must write balanced chemical equation. We should not write about this skeletal chemical equation. We must have to write the balanced chemical equation. I think you understand. So how to make it balanced? So in both sides the number of atom must be same. Let us do another example, how to balance. Let us do another example, barium chloride, there which is given in your textbook in the middle of the chapter, the one question given, question number 2, 2, 2. That one I am doing, so it will be helpful for you also. At the same time, our answer also will be done, and at the same time, you will understand also. So, 2, 2, let us do. They are written, write the balanced equation for the following chemical reaction. Balanced equation. Balanced equation, 2, who are written? Barium chloride. Barium chloride plus aluminium sulfate it forms barium sulfate aluminium chloride plus aluminium chloride. So this is the question. We need to write the balanced chemical equation. So balanced chemical equation of this, we need to write. This is the question. So let us write it. So barium chloride, we don't know the chemical formula of barium chloride. So how to find out the chemical formula? We need to know first the how to find out the chemical formula of barium chloride. So let us see if that one first. So in the answer sheet, that one how to find out the barium chloride chemical formula, that one no need to write. You have to write only the chemical equation. So barium chloride, barium is Ba, chlorine is Cl, valency of Ba is 2, chlorine valency is 1, interchange, then it forms BaCl2. So we can write instead of this barium chloride, we can write BaCl2 plus. Now aluminium sulfate, let us see aluminium sulfate what formula forming. Aluminium
AL, sulfate SO4, aluminum valence is 3, SO4 valence is 2, so interchange AL2, SO4, 3. Under SO4, this 3 will come, that's why bracket required. So AL2, SO4, 3. This is aluminum sulfate. So barium chloride plus aluminum sulfate. Arrow, barium sulfate. Now barium Ba sulfate SO4, Ba is 2, SO4 2, interchange 2 to cancel, so it will be BaSO4. So there will be BaSO4.
Barium sulfate means BaSO4.
Then the last one, last compound is aluminium chloride. Aluminium Al, chloride Cl, aluminium 3, chlorine 1. So interchange, that will be AlCl3, AlCl3 plus AlCl3, AlCl3, aluminium chloride. So this is the way
how we have written the chemical formula of this compound. So by memorizing this chemical symbol, if you are used to write during the exam, it will be very tough and for any person. So it will be better to practice how to form the chemical compound from the name, by the name how to form the chemical compound, that is known to you already. So by this we have written the chemical formula of this every compound whatever written in the question. Now our aim is to balance it. This is not imbalanced, this is unbalanced chemical equation. This is not balanced, this skeletal chemical equation. Why can we say this is not balanced? How can we say? You see aluminium 2, there one aluminium. So there are 2 aluminium, there are 1 aluminium. There are 2 chlorine, there are 3 chlorine. So this is not balanced one. We need to balance it first. So let us try to balance it from the beginning, from the first one. Barium, how many barium there? 1 barium. There also 1 barium. This is balanced. How many chlorine there? 2 chlorine. But here how many chlorine? 3 chlorine. So odd one where? Our aim is to make first odd one even. Where odd one? This one, there are 2 under Cl2 there. So 2 chlorine there. This is even. There under chlorine 3. So this is odd. So there we need to make it first even. So we will give there 2 first. Then whenever they are 2 given, whenever they are 2 given, then aluminium 2, aluminium 2, chlorine became 3 to the 6, but they are 2 only. Chlorine became 3 to the 6, but they are 2 only. So there we need to give 3. So whenever I have given 3 there, then barium became 3, their barium 1, so we need to give there also 3. When I have given barium 3 there, then SO4 3, yes SO4 3 there. Now it is balanced, let us check it. How many barium there? 3 barium, 3 barium. How many chlorine there? 3 to the 6, so 3 to the 6. How many aluminium there? 2 aluminium, so 2 aluminium. How many SO4 there? 3 SO4, so there are 3 SO4. So this is balanced chemical equation. So I think you understand. You can practice how to write the balanced chemical equation. Always you must have to write the balanced chemical equation. By sentence also they can give that barium chloride, when barium chloride reacts with aluminium sulfate, it forms barium sulfate and aluminium chloride. So from that we have to write the chemical equation like this, and then you need to balance it. This is the our question answer, and like this many questions you will get in exercise, and from there you can practice it. Next one is type of chemical reactions. We understand about the what is chemical equation, what is chemical reaction, how to represent the chemical reaction, chemical equation, and then skeletal chemical equation, then balanced chemical equation. Now the type of chemical equation.
We will write now the type of chemical equation. types of chemical equation.
There are many types of chemical equations are there. Chemical equations are of many types. So one by one we'll discuss. Number one, combination reaction.
Combination
reaction. So by the name we can understand that when anything combines together and form a new product, single product, that is the combination reaction. That means in the reactant side, we can say that in reactant side, when more than one compound or elements, more than one compounds or atoms or elements react together, that means two or more elements or atoms or compounds react together and forms a single compound in the product side. Again, I am telling, in the reactant side, more than two elements or atoms or compounds reacts together in the reactant side and forms a new compound, only single new compound in the product side, that is called combination reaction. For example, we can say that
CaO plus H2O.
CaO, you know, this is quicklime, H2O water, and it forms
calcium hydroxide, CaOH2.
Is it balanced? Let us check it. One calcium, one oxygen, 1+1, 2, there are also two hydrogen, so there are also 2 hydrogen. This is balanced chemical equation. Here you see, in the reactant side, two compounds react together and forms a single compound. This is combination reaction. That is, in the reactant size, all combined together and form a single compound, that is combination reaction. Next one, in combination reactions, some other reactions are also there. Exothermic, endothermic reactions. Exothermic reactions, that means if heat is evolved in the product side, after reaction, if heat is evolved in the product side, that is exothermic reaction. If heat is evolved in the product side, that is exothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction, just opposite of that. If heat is required to combine, if heat is required to react, if heat is supplied to react, that means in the reactant side, if heat is required, that is endothermic reaction. In the product side, if heat is evolved, that is exothermic reaction. So these are the another two examples, two types of reactions are there. Our respiration is an exothermic reaction. Our respiration is an exothermic reaction because we respire. When we inhale oxygen inside our body, this reaction taking place, and when we exhale, then carbon dioxide is getting out. This carbon dioxide, whatever getting out, that is hot one, you can check it, this is hot one. So when oxygen we are inhaling, that reacts with the glucose inside our body and forms the carbon dioxide and water. So this carbon dioxide, water, and producing certain amount of energy. That certain amount of energy is evolved in the product side. That means after reactions, this energy is evolved. That is exothermic reaction. Now, if we burn, suppose any cloth or anything, if we burn, then heat has to be supplied. So we are supplying heat, we are providing heat, that is, suppose methane gas, when methane is burned, that means heat is required to supply. So it must cross the ignition temperature of methane. The temperature must be more than the ignition temperature of methane, then the methane will burn. That means we are supplying heat, we are supplying certain amount of heat to the methane, and then methane is burning, that is reacting with oxygen. That is endothermic reaction. but our respiration, inhaling oxygen, reacting with glucose, forming the carbon dioxide and water, and releasing certain amount of energy. So that is exothermic reaction. That is in the product side, heat is evolving. That means energy is evolving. If energy is supplied in the reactant side, that is endothermic. If energy is producing in the product side, that is exothermic. So this is another two types of reaction. Now under our types of reaction, the number two is decomposition reaction. Decomposition reaction, that we can say that this is just opposite of combination reaction. Decomposition reaction is just opposite of combination reaction. In combination reaction, what happens? In the reactant side, all react together and forms a single compound in the product side. That is the combination reaction, just opposite of that. That means here, from single compound, many compound will be formed in the product side. That means in the reactant side only one compound, and in the product side there will be many, but that is more than one or two. So we can say that this is the opposite of combination reaction. That's why decomposition reaction is called opposite of combination reaction. Let us see. Suppose calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate, if heat is supplied to the calcium carbonate, then it forms CaO plus CO2. CaO plus CO2, calcium oxide and then carbon dioxide. You see, in the reactant side only one compound, and in the product side more than one, that is two. So that means this one is broken down into many. So opposite of combination reaction. In combination reactions we are getting many, and in the product side one. In decomposition reaction, in reactant side one, in product side many. So that's why this combination reaction is called opposite of decomposition reaction, or decomposition reaction is called opposite of combination reaction. Under types of chemical equation, number third one is displacement reaction. Displacement reactions, before to understand about the displacement reaction, we need to recall our memory that activity series of metal, there activity series from in that activity series, if we go to downward, then the reactivity of the metal decreases, and at the bottom, which one is there, that is the platinum, that is the least reactive. At the top, potassium, sodium, these are there. So these are the most reactive. So based on the activity series, we can understand easily this decomposition, displacement reaction. Displacement reaction. There, if an iron rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution, if an iron rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution, then this iron is much more reactive than copper. In the activity series, iron is placed above copper. Iron is placed above copper. That means I told earlier that if we go to, from top to bottom in activity series, then the reactivity of the metal decreases continuously. So since iron is placed above copper, so iron is more reactive than copper. Since iron is more reactive than copper, then in this reaction, when iron rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution, this iron will displace copper from its solution. This iron will displace copper from its solution, and it will form FeSO4 plus Cu. It will form FeSO4 plus Cu. So there also color will be changed. This copper sulfate is blue color. This one is blue color, and FeSO4 color is not blue. This is reddish brown, we can say. This is reddish brown. So in this reaction, earlier I told that how can you understand that there is a chemical reaction, there is a change in color. Change in color in chemical reaction also another properties. So from that property we can say that their color is changed. In this displacement reaction, here copper sulfate solution is blue color. This is blue color
and this is reddish brown.
So there you can say that color becomes brownish. We can say that brownish or reddish brown.
You can say brownish also, little deep brown also maybe.
Here color becomes brownish from blue color. Copper sulfur solution is blue color. When iron rod is deep, this becomes brownish and copper is displaced. This is the displacement reaction. This iron more reactive element, more reactive metal displaces a less reactive metal. More reactive metal displaces a less reactive metal. That's why the reaction name is displacement reaction. Our fourth one is double displacement reaction.
Double displacement
fourth one is double displacement reaction. Here displacement will take place two times. Suppose sodium sulfate Na2
Na2SO4
when reacts with sodium sulfate Na2SO4 when reacts with barium chloride BaCl2. Sodium sulfate reacting with barium chloride, then it forms barium sulfate BaSO4 plus NaCl. Let us see first, is it balanced or not? Two sodium, they are one sodium, so there will be two. When they are two given, then chlorine became two, they are chlorine two. SO4 one, SO4 one, barium one, barium one. Now it is balanced. So this is their double displacement taking place. You see, with sodium SO4 is there and with barium chlorine is there. When they react together, this SO4 is displaced there and chlorine is displaced there. You see, SO4 has gone there, so BaSO4 formed with Ba and chlorine came here and NaCl formed. So the displacement of the compound or element taking place two times, there one, there two. So two times displacement taking place, that's why it is called double displacement reaction. So another one, oxidation reduction.
Our fifth one is and the types of reaction, oxidation reduction.
Oxidation reduction reaction. Oxidation reduction reaction togetherly called redox reaction. Togetherly called redox reaction. Togetherly called redox reaction. They are, for example, suppose CuO plus H. H2,
CuO plus H2, Cu plus H2O.
Is it balanced? Yes, balanced. So oxidation reduction reaction togetherly called redox reaction. Oxidation means where oxygen is added. Oxidation means where oxygen is added. That is the oxidation reaction. And reduction reaction means where hydrogen is added or oxygen is removed. Either hydrogen added or oxygen removed, that is reduction reaction. And oxidation means where oxygen is added or hydrogen is removed, that is the oxidation reaction. So let us see there how to find out the which one is oxidation, which one is reduction. This is the example of redox reaction. That is, both are there. Oxidation also there, reduction also there. This is the example of redox reaction. So there you see, here Cu, there Cu. Here CuO, there Cu. Copper oxide, there only copper. So
from copper oxide to copper.
From copper oxide to copper. Here oxygen is there, but in the product side oxygen is not there. In the reactant side oxygen is there, copper oxide, but in the product side oxygen is there, not there. Simply copper is there. So this is called reduction reaction. From Cu to Cu, CuO to Cu reduction, CuO to Cu reduction.
There from H2 to H2O.
Here only hydrogen, but there with hydrogen oxygen is there. That means oxygen we can say added. Here oxygen is removed. Here oxygen is removed. Here oxygen is there, but oxygen is not there. So oxygen is removed. Since oxygen is removed, so that's why this is reduction reaction. There oxygen is added. Here oxygen is not there, but in this side oxygen is there. So that's why this is called oxidation reaction. So I think you understand better that this one is oxidation, this one is reduction. In the oxidation reaction you see oxygen is added. In the product side oxygen there. In the reactant side oxygen is not there with hydrogen. In the product side H2O, so oxygen is added with H2. Here oxygen is removed. In the reactant side copper oxide CuO, but in the product side here only Cu. So CuO and Cu, in the product side oxygen is not there, only Cu. So that's why oxygen is removed, we can say that's why it is reduction reaction. So this is the example of redox reaction. So like this, many examples of redox reaction there in your textbook, some exercise, in your exercise some reactions given. You have to need to identify which one is oxidation, which one is reductions. From there you can understand, you can identify easily, and that one you do it. The next one is corrosion. Corrosion, that means you know, rust is forming in iron, rusting of iron, this is the example of corrosion. That means iron, when under different climatic condition, iron reacting with the moisture and forming the rust, that is the example of corrosion. Like this, many metals are there which are destroyed due to corrosion, which may destroy due to corrosion, due to heat, due to moisture, due to sunlight, due to temperature, that reaction may take place, that is called corrosion. So rusting of iron, that means iron oxide forming, when iron rod reacting with the oxygen, there is the moisture, iron oxide forming, this is the rusting of iron, and this is the example of corrosion. So corrosion means there is the chemical change in the metal, and when reacting with the moisture, heat, in the rainy season, in the winter season, in the dry season, in the summer season, and if we don't care, if we keep iron rod for long time, then we can see the rust is formed on the body of that iron rod. So this is the example of corrosion. Rancidity, that the food or oil that got spoiled, rancidity. Rancidity, that is food or the oil gets spoiled due to the reaction with the oxygen. That means oxidation of food, this is the oxidized food. When the food comes in contact with the oxygen, that becoming spoiled, then this is called rancidity. Now corrosion, rancidity, how can we get rid of both of these? Now corrosion can be prevented in many ways. Number one, by painting. If we paint it on the body of the iron, then that corrosion can be prevented. Number two, by greasing. Number three, by with the help of galvanization. Galvanization means a layer of zinc and chromium is formed on the surface of the iron, and that can prevent the iron from this corrosion. So from this rust, and that iron will not form any rust, and that can be prevented. So corrosion can be prevented by this. Another process is there, continuously you have to clean it. If you keep it clean continuously and keep inside and take away from the moisture, then that also can be prevented. Rancidity, in the market chips, then like that chips, then oil, these are kept under a packet. Inside that packet, nitrogen gas is supplied. That nitrogen gas does not allow that food containing inside the packet to come in contact with the oxygen, and that helps the food to remain in good condition. So whenever we are purchasing this packet food, that means chips or oil or like that some other, their nitrogen is entered there, and which does not allow to come in contact with oxygen, and that prevent from the rancidity. So this way we can prevent the food from the rancidity. Now in your textbook, many questions are there, some we have discussed. How to write the balanced chemical equation, how to write the chemical equation, what is balanced chemical equation, so endothermic, exothermic reaction, what are these, why decomposition reaction is called positive combination reactions, this everything I have discussed. And about the oxidation reduction reaction, this redox reaction, that one also I have discussed. So you try all this whatever they are in the exercise, starting from the beginning. Most of this you can, one example I am showing, this one answer I am showing, balance the following equation I have shown. Another one I am showing, suppose they are written, hydrogen gas combined with nitrogen to form ammonia. Hydrogen gas combined with nitrogen to form ammonia. Hydrogen gas combined with nitrogen to form ammonia. So they have asked to write the, translate the statement. This is the statement equation, and we need to write the chemical equation of this statement, as well as we need to balance it. So let us do it. Hydrogen gas, that means H2 combined with nitrogen, nitrogen also we are writing as N2, ammonia, that means NH3. NH3 is the chemical formula of ammonia. How NH3? Nitrogen valency is 3, hydrogen valency is 1, interchange, then it will be NH3. So we need to balance it first. Now 2 hydrogen, there are 3 hydrogen, odd, there is odd one, so we need to make it even first. So there I have to give 2, so whenever I have given 2, then nitrogen became 2, there nitrogen 2, hydrogen became 3 to 6, but there are 2, there I have to give 3. So now it is balanced, that means 3 hydrogen combining with 1 nitrogen then form 2 ammonia. So this is the balanced chemical equation, and this year you practice your exercise. I wish that you can understand all the question and you can write all the answers. So thank you, and I wish that you understand the chapter, and whatever the questions there in your exercise inside the chapter and the final exercise, I wish that you can do this answer and you can solve and throughout my discussion you understand and try to relate my discussion with the chapter. You go through the chapter by reading and match the try to remember my discussion and try to match that discussion with the chapter, and then you can understand in better way. And I wish that you can write all the question answer of this chapter. Thank you.